Was, of course, what happens when you have a good show, where it wasn't geared around girls or boys, it was just a good show. So kind of everybody started to watch it, and it had an amazing longevity, which we didn't expect.
No. Well, what was it like being Ron Stoppable, kicking butt, taking names next to Christy? What was that?
I think it was, yeah, he was just trying to hold his pants up, wasn't it? No, it was good. It was one of those things where the character kind of started one way, and then he kind of slowly started to get more and more Ron Stoppable, and then by the end, he was just like a totally crazy kind of guy in love with Kim. So it was, it definitely changed, and the thing that was strange was I was doing Batman Beyond and Kim Possible at the same time. So I would, you know, leave in the morning of being like this. I just bought this. He's going, hey, where are my cans? It was certainly a very strange transition between the two.
Was this stressful on your voice?
No, it was a ton of fun. It really was because, one's in the way lower register, so it's more in your chest. And then the Ron's up kind of in the back of your throat, so there wasn't really screeching, which is good. It's when you get into the video games that really shrink. Yes.
Do you guys ever get to record together, or in the studio do you have to record separately?
So what we were saying was we really only got to record together, but you did, generally, KP did the show recorded with other actors.
Well, my normal crew was, I would be, every week I was normally with Johnny DiMaggio, who played Dr. Dragon, and Nicole Sullivan, who is Sheba. So the three of us would be together, and then more often than not, Christy's voice would be piped in, but a lot of times we didn't even do that. It was just kind of the three of us recording together. Because we were in Los Angeles and she was in New York and she was in school, so the schedule was a little different, but we were able to kind of record together. And as for cartoons as a whole, it really depends on the company you're working with. Hasbro really likes to record in a big room. Warner Brothers, you're usually with everybody, and then it's like a straight radio play. There's, 15 or 20 people in a room sometimes, and we all have a microphone, and you start at the beginning and you read the script straight through. And then there's some companies where you're recording by yourself, which isn't as, it's still fun because you're doing one of the greatest jobs in the world, but it's certainly not as fun as being able to play off of all the other actors that are there.
A lot of video games companies that I work alongside say they record separately, and yeah. To me, I think as a voice, as an actor voice actor, that takes such skill. You have to evoke these emotions with no one to play off of.
Yeah, it's also, video games are different because it's, video games back in the day, it was like you had your little character and go ding 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 and it would run one direction, and if you ask the voiceover actor, you go, or something, and that would be it. Whereas nowadays you get a book that's like this thick because it's all about the player. So if you turn one way, one story is gonna happen. You turn another way, another story is gonna happen. If you get shot in the leg in a bad way, you have to make one sound. If you get nicked, you make another. So you're in the booth for 5 hours a day, for 20 sessions. And you're shredding your voice and the script is this thick. So it's certainly, it's more difficult to do video games in a large group of people just because they're so intricate, there's so much to do nowadays. Whereas doing a show, you start to, you bop along, when you're doing Guardians of the Galaxy or Transformers, we've been doing it for so long, the whole kind of crew is together, and you get in, your character, and you can get off around, so it's a ton of fun.
I love your Twitter.